Humanity's expansion into space will happen much faster than you think. The availability of microgravity and partial artificial gravity will enable activities and ventures that you just can't do on Earth. Activities such as manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, tourism, and many others. The question is, what are the steps that move us toward that? We're in the midst of the first step right now, a dramatic decrease in the cost of launching to space. This enables activities to be profit-making now that 10 years ago were uneconomical. The next step, these payloads need some place to go, a destination. And the great majority of these activities will need pressurized vessels containing air. They need water, they need power, they need thermal control so you don't get too hot or too cold. And of course, particular commercial activities require specialized facilities and services. Finally, we need to bring some of these payloads back to Earth. Right now, the only facility providing all those is the International Space Station. But the problem is the ISS was designed as a research and development facility, not as a full-scale production facility. Space is limited, thermal control is limited, power is limited, and because of that, access is limited. That means there are thousands of commercial missions bottlenecked by the ISS and clamoring for an alternative. That is the need above is addressing. Meet Prometheus, a modular infrastructure platform that meets a wide range of government and commercial applications. Prometheus offers in months instead of years access to custom pressurized environments, facilities, and services to support the needs of on-orbit product development and manufacturing at a fraction of the price of the ISS. Above greatly reduces costs by hosting multiple payloads on each flight with automation and using low-risk commercial off-the-shelf technologies. COTS technologies are very important because they avoid the cost, schedule, and performance risk of developing new technologies. Prometheus enables the development of the next generation of commercial space companies and is the cornerstone of our development program leading to long-term habitable space stations. The key to securing first-mover advantage is heritage. The above team, with its decades of experience in space flight, space technologies, and mission architecture, is ideally positioned to take advantage of commercial off-the-shelf technologies, putting them together in creative ways to do things that have never been done before. Between myself and Robert Miyake, we have enough experience in spaceflight missions and operations to know what works in space and what doesn't work in space, and this greatly reduces the risks for the missions that we're designing in the future. And that's why the Department of Defense has entrusted us with a contract to develop our Archimedes platform, a platform that is rapidly deployable and a flat surface that supports many different applications such as radar, high data rate communications, and energy transmission and generation. My colleagues and I started above because we realized we had a fast track to allow humanity to move to space and to make a profit doing so. We already have the letters of commitment to make this profitable from the very first mission. Prometheus is the next step in a wide range of critical infrastructure solutions. This is happening. We are going. And in phase two, we'll begin to offer return of payloads to Earth. If you believe in the mission of providing more space in space, join us.